Hi, I'm Sara Clarin. I'm a member of the Notre Dame women's rowing team, and today we are going to read Friends of a Feather. Written by Arlen Cohn, illustrated by Dawn Sullivan. I was sitting and looking for something to do, just scraping some gum off the sole of my shoe, when out of nowhere, a feather just landed on me. A quite lovely feather with all different hues. There were misty blue greens and metallic green blues. I don't know where it came from, it seemed so absurd, but I knew I must find this strange, fabulous bird. I grabbed a feather. A feather this lovely would surely be missed, so I grabbed the zoo animal resident list. I give it back that feather before I was through. After all, I'd been told, it's the right thing to do. After running inside to pack up my spy glasses, some rope, a canteen, and a camera with flashes, 28 cents and a marble or two, a compass, a watch, and my new hiking shoes, I was set to investigate the Zimmerfield Zoo. With feather in hand, I commenced with my search, looking every which way for a bird or a perch. I was plotting a course on my Zimmerfield map when a toucan appeared and sat down in my lap. You're a beautiful bird, but there's only one catch. The feather I have and your feathers don't match. I fastened my rope the branch of a tree, and climbed up to determine just what I might see. And when a woodpecker started in pecking on me, I shooed him away and climbed down from my rope. That's the last time I see a woodpecker, I hope. I followed some bird tracks through the zoo grounds. You wouldn't believe what I finally found. The most marvelous ostrich you ever will see, although the view I had was just eyeball to knee, and with feathers so big that they terrified me. It's a big ostrich. When I caught my composure, I glanced up to see a high-flying bird that was circling me, a black-feathered vulture with shifty dark eyes, who seemed to be looking at smallish type guys. So I stood on my tiptoes before he got eyes. I cautiously stepped to the minor bird's nest to ask if he might be of help in my quest. Hello, Mr. Mina. Hello, he spoke back. I'm looking for feathers, but yours are all black. I could tell this discussion was going nowhere. I hiked past a waterfall and a beehive when I noticed some penguins preparing to dive. I raced by so fast that I just couldn't see if their feathers were like those that fell upon me. I was trying to escape from a huge bumblebee. That bee was still gaining, I'm sorry to say, when a red-bearded bee-eater fluttered his way. When the bee got one look at that oncoming beak, he started to shake at the stomach, he got weak. He no longer wanted to chase me, I feel. He was scared of becoming a bee-eater's meal.